took so freaking long getting ready, and I was really, really excited. When I came to school, I was like, girl, bye. This is really not what I expected.
But your love's too original. You were anything but original. Baby, did you know that from the moment we fell in and knew we could? Knowing I give it right. If it all goes away,
y'all get ready with me for my first day of school, sophomore year, and I will be doing a little chit chat about freshman year so you guys can know more about it. Most of you are so excited to go to the first day of school because y'all think that it's gonna be fun, you're gonna expect something to change, to see faces. I was also the same. Like last year, I took so freaking long getting ready, and I was really, really excited. When I came to school, I was like, girl, bye. This is really not what I expected. I literally had to call my best friend and tell her, oh my god, this is literally not what I expected. It was just a normal school day, but the difference was, it's just coming back to school after long breaks. Get prepared to get lost, because last year I got so lost and everything was just new to me, so I had to ask different teachers for directions. Just get prepared unless you do the orientation, whatever. A lot of students get bad grades when they come out of school. That should definitely happen to you. So last year there was this new girl called Zaza. Actually, her real name is not Zaza, but I'm gonna nickname her Zaza. So she was really smart and pretty, but when she started prioritizing parties, hangouts, and all that stuff, her grades went down, and she had really, really strict parents. They grounded her, but that was not the only thing. She had to catch up, but she found it difficult to catch up. Grades did not improve anymore, and she lost her scholarship. Most people think that when they come to high school, because of like what they see in the movies or what they hear people saying and stuff, they just want to like have fun. But you can still have fun and actually work. I consider those who actually know how to balance their time and stuff. A lot of you want to make friends or one or two friends, but you're actually scared to start the conversation or keep the conversation going. You're not scared of talking in reality, but you're just scared of what people will actually think of you, because I've been there. So last year I was literally like this shy kid who wouldn't say hi to you. I would never say hi to you if you didn't say hi to first, because I was literally so scared. I was nervous. I was like, wait, what if he doesn't respond? What if she thinks I'm weird? All those type of like assumptions. I just didn't have the courage for it. But one way I fixed that was by time. I gave myself time and stopped focusing on making friends. I just focused on having fun with the friends or with the people I already knew and getting my work done. When people see you having fun and actually getting your work done, living your life, they're gonna want to come in and join. That's how the vibe matches and it goes with the flow, because friendship is really not something you just get in a snap of fingers. It's a natural process. So you have to take your time and stop focusing on making new friends, because if you keep focusing on making new friends, then you're just gonna make things awkward. You see a lot of like people getting closer or close just because of extracurricular activities. I mean, that's really a cool thing, but personally me, I like staying in my corner, chilling and just doing what me does. Last school year, the first semester, I decided to join cheer, and that was like my first time. I was liking the vibe, everything was going smooth, and the friends there were really nice and stuff, and I met a lot of new faces and stuff. But when it was time to perform for real, I was so scared. Like, I had goosebumps, my hands were were shaking. I felt like I was about to faint. I felt so uncomfortable on the stage because this was my first year of high school, and I thought that everybody was paying attention to you. Everybody was ready to criticize you. Yes, there are some people who actually never mind their business and stuff, but nobody really cares about you because they all have their personal issues and goals. You should not be worrying about that, and that is a nice way to make friends or meet new people. My favorite part, which is boys, drama, and all that stuff, I'm gonna like give you a little story time. So last year, as you already know, I was like the shy kid and the quiet kid. There was this new kid called Chris. He was a new kid from New York, and there was also this girl called Zaza. So Zaza was like pretty and stuff, and she was popular, and she was much more of a dramatic girl. So before Easter break, Zaza was always sticky and clingy around Chris, and I'm like, bro, be so real. But it was none of my business, so I just kept quiet and I just mind my business, and I did not even want to get involved in any drama, because getting involved in drama was just like a waste of time for it. One afternoon, I'm in my house, I'm chilling, I see a Snapchat request from Chris. I'm like, Chris, that is so weird, because I did not like Chris at all. I didn't even want to talk to Chris, because when Chris came into school, he was like, girls in my class are trying to get my attention. It was like everybody, and I do not like people who are like that, because it's like you're so ahead of yourself. Do not fuck with that, for real. So I accepted the friend request because I didn't think of anything weird or anything. Right away, he texted me and he was like, yo. And then we started texting from that day, and he was okay to be around. He wasn't like I thought he would be, but he was still this nonchalant, I don't give a fuck guy. But okay, so we started texting every single day. I couldn't continue or keep up with that, so I had to stop it because I had like school exams were coming up. I had my YouTube, and before all that happened, when we would text, Chris would be like, my heart. So my heart was like a way of saying bro in New York. He would just write MH. So the next day, I see Zaza crying in lunchtime, like literally in lunchtime. Zaza crying is one of the biggest shocks of my life, because Zaza was the type of girl to be like, oh, I would never cry. You would never catch me crying in school. If you didn't know her, you would think that this girl is heartless. She does not have emotions and stuff. I was really, really shocked. I wanted to know, but then I was like, it's none of my business. And I don't really even talk to Zaza because we had like a little beef. So I just mind my business. But since I was that quiet girl who everybody trusted with their secrets, my classmate came and was like, Prestige, guess what? Zaza is crying. Zaza went through Chris's phone and she saw the text message Chris sent you. And Zaza also got rejected. And I was like, wait, that is so raw. Chris and I were not messing with each other, and I do not have time for that. Like, I have a lot of studies, I have school, and I have all that. I just decided to mind my business and stick to what I was doing. Zaza started, like, paying attention in class. She started looking better. She, like, started having more fun with her friends. Everything just got back to normal. Me thinking everything is over and stuff. 1 week later, a rumor spread of me and Chris messing with each other, and that rumor was just not in high school, but it was also in middle school. So imagine how rumors spread so freaking quick. Like, I was like, no way. But that's it for today.